would like to know what you did with that adhesive after filming. You know, I heard, I believe they gave it to you, and what did you do with it?
You mean that very last day when I managed to get that last piece of prosthetic off? I threw it straight on the brazier in the thing, and I watched it hiss and burn away. And if you ever hear that I'm wearing a full prosthetic, I don't mean just a tiny little blob on the nose or something like that, a full prosthetic makeup again, please know that I am either earning a disgusting amount of money every day, or I'm just truly senile. They're all different, and you understand there are very well-trained actors who've got very, very set routines. And I'm not really like that, probably because I have a low attention span or just a high sense of irritation or something like that. You read a character, and there's just something about him, and he starts living in your head. And you start, in the middle of conversations with people, you suddenly go, "Nobody tosses a dwarf." No, that doesn't work. That doesn't work. That's too Welsh. Anyway, it's the elves that are Welsh. What about an Irish dwarf? "Nobody tosses a dwarf." No. What about Northern Irish? "Nobody tosses a dwarf." And then you think, no, Scottish. The Scottish dwarves are the meanest dwarves. "Nobody tosses a dwarf." Of course they do. I mean, it's tragic for those pretty boys who, you know, who've been top of the bill, you know, from the age of 22, 23, till 42, 43, and then suddenly there's another range of 22-year-olds pushing forward. Missed! always pushing from behind, whereas, you know, character actors just go on and on and on.
That's true. You said Tolkien knew that civilization is worth fighting for. There are times when a generation is challenged and must fight to defend the civilization from annihilation. How does this apply to modern times?
You think I'm going to walk into that mind?
I figured, you know, I'll put it nicely and, you know, just push it out there.
"Turning and turning in the widening gyre, the falcon cannot hear the falconer. Things fall apart. The center cannot hold. Mere anarchy is loosed upon the world. The best lack all conviction, and the worst possess a passionate intensity." That's what I've got to say about that.
Well, thank you.
That, of course, is Yeats,
yes.
Whom I urge you to read. He's a wonderful poet. Wonderful, wonderful poet.
Do you judge the characters you play, or or you play, do you have a moment you say, oh, I don't like this character? Do you have like a negative or positive? Do you ever have a moment where you judge them, or you just simply wait?
Parts are very much like children. There are times you don't like them, but you love them always.
Right.
Most actors create characters out of love. I mean, you take a character like Gimli. Gimli is what is worst in us. He is narrow, he is xenophobic, he is hostile, he is aggressive. He is that part of us, but he's also the person who's capable of the most wonderful friendship and generosity and absolutely being there for you. And courage. Bring on a 1,000 orcs or something like that, and if he could be on his own, he'd be saying, come on, bring it on. What's that wonderful line? Certainty of death, small chance of success. What are we waiting for? Let's get on with it.
Other than surviving and reproducing
is the need to pass on his history, to pass on his knowledge. And once you lose a generation of knowledge, you know, everything really collapses.
True.
Every generation experiences a life from the beginning, but if you didn't have what came before you, how do you accrue things? How do you grow?
How do you develop? How do you move forward? I'd like to open their Q&A to their audience. Please, if anybody has any questions, please just, there's somebody with a microphone in the middle. Queue up in the middle and ask the question, and Mr. Davis, you definitely ask it.
And let me just anticipate one question. Girls, I'm terribly sorry, I do not actually happen to possess Orlando Bloom's personal phone number.
My favorite was always Sala, and I wanted to know, are you coming back to the next indie?
For the TV show?
No. No, the movie.
You're going to have to interpret for me because I'm old and deaf and pathetic.
All right.
But did you say you loved Sala and would I go back and play him again?
Yes.
In the next movie. Yes, I hope so. I mean, I don't know. I don't know whether he fits in for the next show, but I think he's actually important culturally for some of the reasons that I've adduced here. But yes, I think he is. I think he is important enough to come back.
Yeah.
But then the great Indiana Jones is the most. He is Prince Hamlet, not Salah.
Yes. Or maybe Salah has a daughter or a son. Maybe he has a son or a daughter in the next show.
Well, you never know. The son, Indy's sons are probably, he's probably more reproductively successful than any camel. Probably got little cabinets all over the world.
Next question, please.
Hi, nice to see you here. I see that your outfit is exactly like Professor Arturo's from the Sliders. I wanted to ask you, from all the very famous movies that you made, Sliders, Lord of the Rings, Shannara Chronicles, Indiana Jones, which one is the role which you identify the most? Which one was the easiest to play for you?
If your question is, which is my favorite part?
No, not your favorite part. Which was the easiest, the easiest to play?
Which is easier.
And most difficult also. Sorry, forgot. Easiest and most difficult.
They all start off hard and they end up getting easier, I think. Except Treebeard, which started off so seemingly simple and got harder and harder and harder and still wakes me up at night. I haven't got it. I don't know how to answer. I don't know how to answer your question. I was trying to find a way out by simply saying, if you ask me what my favorite part is, it's the next one. It's the next one.
Was there any moment during shooting the Lord of the Rings when you make something that wasn't planted and then in the end they think that, okay, we'll keep it, or... And so... sorry.
Kannst einfach durchfragen, ich übersetze.
Entschuldigen
Sie bitte.
No,
Oh, it's a hobbit.
Was there any moment in the movie when you make something different from the script and then they think, okay, we will keep it, but you improvise something and they think that's it's so good, we will keep it?
I do improvise, yes. Some people think this is clever. It's probably got to do with the fact that I get bored very quickly doing the same thing over and over again. And my mind starts wandering and I... You know, when I was a little boy at school, my very first school report at the age of 5 said, John could do very well. As soon as he realizes that life is not a joke. I'm still working on it.
Hello.
And I'm sorry I'm deaf, but then so is he. Is now paired up with a hobbit.